Hey up, it's Sean at ESC United, your favourite Eurovision channel. You know the score, you've seen the title, you know what we're doing today. It's Norway once again. It's time for the third semi-final of Melodi Grand Prix this weekend, and we've got four more acts to look forward to and also another pre-qualifier. I'm going to take a look and see if there's anything this week to get excited about and to see if Norway have any potential stars and their hands in this selection. So let's jump straight into it. Let's have a look at these songs and let's see what I think of these on my first reaction. I'm straight in there with the shouting. Straight in with the attitude. Wow. That's how you grab an artist. That's how you grab a audience, sorry. I'm getting excited. I'm getting flustered. My words have gone already. It's like sort of pop punk style. Very American. Yeah. This is strong already. This is very Olivia Rodrigo, I feel. Bit of old style Avril Lavigne. Wow. Wow, this is, I can't keep up with this. There's so many elements to this. If she can produce this live, my wow, we've got a strong song here. This is very current because there's a lot of artists that I hear on the radio. You know, reminds me a bit of Griff, of Gail, Olivia Rodrigo. There's a lot of artists like this at the minute who have that sort of angsty, angry sound. You know, very sort of personal empowerment anthems. And this is another one. This is already like, this is probably the strongest sort of overall. Could be a radio hit, could be a really strong song, could be a fan favourite out of the three semi-finals I've heard so far. Definitely compared to the first two, anyway. Come on. Yep. There we go. There we go. Big moment. This is so well structured and put together. Like, doesn't miss a trick within the 3 minutes. Give this a really energetic and strong performance, and this is going to be a very strong contender. Wow, great start. Hammer of four. Really? I already kind of know what this is going to be like. I think, anyway. But I know from people I know on the forum and in the Eurovision community, this type of music, if I think it is, if I, it's what I think it is, then it's going to be a very popular one. Big voice. Very atmospheric. But I stole the hammer of Thor. I stole the hammer of Thor. Ooh, tempo change. That's nice. This is very folkloric, traditional. Very Norwegian in a way, it feels. And the tempo's jumped back down again. A lot of this is going to hinge on the aesthetics that they can produce on screen and on the stage. This isn't the type of song that I would really choose to listen to personally in studio, but I know there's a lot of power in songs like this for a lot of people, so see if you can unleash that this weekend. certainly be different. I'm trying to think of an entry that we've had like this at Eurovision before. I don't think we have. I do like the tempo changes. It do add something completely different to what we have. It's just not enough really to grab my interest, but I like to try and be an objective, and I can appreciate the quality with this. Like, this is gonna have some big, big fans. I know it will. And I can't imagine there's many countries at this year's Eurovision that will have a song like this, so it'll certainly be something to differentiate from the pack. Well, that's an interesting one. What's in Norwegian? That's what I can tell you right now. It's gonna be like an up-tempo pop, piano pop song, I think. It feels like that. Okay, where is it going? Ooh. I thought it'd be like a bigger chorus there. Maybe it's coming. Oh, I don't know what to make of this one. You know, I thought it'd be more up tempo than this. I've been led on here. This is more of a ballad than I thought it would be. It's production's beautiful on it. And this is one that you could really, you could see this having a story played out on stage and really emote the lyrics. And I don't know what the lyrics are. Guessing it's about love or heartbreak. I'm guessing that's what Shirt is hearts. Could be wrong. Part of me is kind of disappointed that it isn't more up tempo than it is, but I feel like this has got replay quality. I'm gonna come back to this one, I think. Because it's got a really nice way of shifting through the gears throughout the song. Well, we got there in the end. I quite enjoyed that. Make a rain, make a rain, rainmaker. Looking over my shoulder, out into the darkness. Am I too paranoid? I guess it's irrational. Always ready to run if I'm walking. Another sort of Scandi pop song. Let's see what you got. Heartbeat racing, I feel naked and I hate it. That was a nice little way of breaking up the verse and the chorus. Did like that. It's a bit formulaic other than that though so far. A little bit 90s sounding, but that's not a bad thing. Not at all. It's making a comeback. We're going through the decades, we're repeating ourselves here, decade after decade. Got a really pleasant voice to listen to. Yeah, I like that bit. That can really lend to some interesting staging as well. You need to throw in elements like that to make it stand out. I'm a little bit underwhelmed. Some really nice elements to it. Like I kind of like the 90s nostalgic pop sound of it. And again, I feel like this is one that's got replay value, but on the first listen, it's just not quite grabbing me. It is a little bit Rainmaker, actually. This is a tough semi-final, though, you know. Probably strongest one so far. This could be one that comes alive with the live performance, so I'm interested to see where this goes this weekend. Like a, yeah, that was pleasant listen. I'll probably come back to that. Now I have no idea what I'm letting myself in for here. I've heard rumours about this song. I've heard people talking about it. This isn't what I expected. Yet. What the hell? Is this Elvis? I've heard that this could be Elvis. Well, it's different, I'll give it that. Ooh. I don't know what the hell to make of this. You know when you don't know what to expect, but it still surprises you? That's a tough ask. This is about like Red Riding Hood or something. I'm so confused. Where does a grandma come into this? Where do wolves come into this? Where do bananas come into this? There's no... What's the story behind this video? What's the story behind these guys? I love it. Okay, really taking a risk putting this one pre-qualified, I think. I guess they need something in the final to have a bit of a novelty factor about it, I guess. I think going into this, I thought it'd be more like electro than it is, just looking at the picture, but it's actually got a bit of pop potential, this. A bit of virality about it. Not sure I told you, but I really like your teeth. That hairy coat of yours with nothing on your teeth. You have a name, so I will call you Keith. Wow. Okay, very first impression I want to say is that that is by far the strongest semi-final we've had in this selection so far. I think all four songs really had a lot to offer, actually, in reflection. I think a couple of them didn't quite hit on the first listen, potentially, but particularly, I think, with Stühler and with Veal, the last two songs, I could see myself personally, my personal taste, I could see them becoming part of my rotation. Eventually, I could see them being a grower with me. But Mary Boller, sorry if I'm butchering these names, by the way, first song, wow, really stand out for me, I think. Very current sound. could do really well on a televote, I think. And again, it hinges on the live performance. I think all four of these do actually. Hammer of Four is going to have a lot of fans. I know it will. It's not my taste at all. I'm sorry, but I can appreciate what's there. It's going to be something certainly very different to anything else we'll get in touring, I'm sure. So that could be an interesting one. And again, you know, Norway, as I've said it last couple of videos, I think I've said this, they're not afraid to experiment with the genres, which to their credit, you know, I think Scandinavian music has a lot of variety. And I'm going to be controversial and say I think only Norway and potentially Finland, of the Nordic countries, maybe a bit of Iceland, actually showcase that diversity and originality in their selections. So well done, NRK, for that. Subwoolfer, just as a shout out. I've no idea what I expected there. But I wasn't expecting that. And I kind of was a little bit underwhelmed, but at the same time, I loved it. And the lyrics were crap. And a lot of it was crap, but it was also really good. So I don't really know what to think about that one. That's going to have to take some time to grow on me. And I think a live performance is going to need to show me the way with that one. I think I loved it. I'm not too sure. But overall, again, another one I can't call, and I probably shouldn't call because I was wrong in the last 2 weeks, just on my taste. And I know that the live performances can make or break these songs this year. So I'm really interested to see what happens this weekend with these four, and particularly with Subwoolfer as well, if they can perform. I want to see what that's all about. But yeah, that's pretty much it from my thoughts on that one. Let me know what you think because this is a really interesting selection this weekend in particular. I want to know who your favourites are, who you've enjoyed in the previous weeks as well. Have I got anything to look forward to in that final semi-final next week? Is this, you know, someone that's going to steal the whole show? I want to know because I've not got there yet. So yeah, let me know in the comments below what you thought. Hopefully you enjoyed the video. If you did, please give us a like and subscribe and obviously put the notification bell on to know when we next upload. There'll be plenty more content coming from us in the next couple of weeks. So stick around and yeah, let me know what you thought and I'll see you again soon.